Learn how to add a health system to your game that includes invulnerability after taking damage. You'll also learn how to add an invulnerability animation to provide the player with visual feedback that the character has taken damage and is temporarily invincible. Howdy, and welcome to Game Endeavor. Learn practical dev skills and improve the quality of your games by subscribing and ding-a-linging that bell. If you're going to include combat in your game, then short of dying in one hit, you're almost certainly going to need to add a health system. But we can't just add a health variable, dust off your hands, and call it done. There are a few other systems that we need to implement along with it, so let's go ahead and get started. Before we can implement our health variable, we probably want to know what our maximum health can be. So we'll create an export variable named maxHealth and give it a default value. We're using an export here because you may use this for various characters through inheritance, and if you have this as an export, then you can easily define the maximum health for the individual character. Now we'll add an onReady variable named health, which we'll use to keep track of our current health. It's an onReady variable because we're going to be setting this to the value of maxHealth, which we won't know the value of until runtime due to it being an export. We're also going to add a couple of signals, just in case we ever want to announce the status of our character. So we'll create a signal named healthUpdated, which will send a value of health. This will be emitted whenever our health is changed. We're also going to create a signal killed, which we'll call whenever our character runs out of health. We want some logic to be performed whenever our health changes, so we're going to use setGet for our health variable, telling it to use the method setHealth, which we will go ahead and define. It will need a value, which is what health should be set to. Health at 0 means that the character is incapacitated, and a health at max health means that the character is fully healed. So we don't want health to be less than 0 or greater than max health. We can easily do this by saying health equals clamp value 0 max health. We want to know if our health has changed, so before setting this, we should store it inside of a temporary variable named previous health. And after we've changed health, we will check to see if health is not equal to previous health. If this is true, then our health has changed, and so we should emit the signal healthUpdated, passing to it our new health value. Then we want to check and see if our character has been incapacitated. So we'll check to see if health is equal to 0. If this is true, then we're going to want to call a method for handling the death logic, which I will call kill. I'll leave the implementation up to you, since it will vary wildly in your game. You could create particles, play a fancy little animation, and or start a timer to despawn the character. I would suggest using a state machine to prevent oddities such as the player jumping while incapacitated. There's an iCard in the corner to watch my video on state machines. Then we'll emit our killed signal, in case anything out there wants to know of our demise. Ideally, you would never use this variable or method outside of this class, though there may be a need to. Instead, we're going to create a damaged method to handle that for us, because you may want more information than the value to set health to. For now, we're just going to have a parameter named amount, which is how much damage to deal to the player. You could include other information though, such as the type of damage. Maybe your character takes half damage for blunt objects. This is where you would implement that. To damage our player, we're going to be lowering their health, so we'll call the setHealth method. We need to pass to it the value that we want our health to be, which will be health minus amount. And with that, the setHealth variable will handle all of the logic we just created. As this is though, we could call the damage method repeatedly, and the character would take damage just as fast as we could call it. However, most games will have a period of invulnerability to prevent this. This is especially important for the player, as it allows them a moment to think about how to escape danger and get to a safe area. Luckily, this is pretty simple. All we need to do is add a timer to our character, making sure to enable one shot, because we only want this to fire once. As for the duration, you may want to give the player plenty of time, but don't overdo it. For enemies, they don't need long at all, otherwise the player will get frustrated with how infrequently they can damage the enemies. I will then cache the timer inside of an onReady variable named invulnerability timer. And then back in the damage method, we will check to see if invulnerability timer is stopped. If true, then we're good to deal the damage. So that's where we'll call our setHealth method. But we need to remember to start the timer, otherwise we went through all of this effort in vain. If you're going to add invulnerability, then I believe it is absolutely crucial that you visually convey this to the player, otherwise you're going to confuse them, or even frustrate them if it's on an enemy. So we're going to add a visual effect for the invulnerability. While we're at it, since it's so closely related, we're also going to add a damage flash to the character to show that they took damage. For these effects, I have an animation player dedicated to them. This animation player has three animations. A rest animation, whose purpose is to restore any settings altered by any of the animations in this player. A damage animation that turns the character red and then back to normal. I will be doing this by adjusting the modulus of the body, which is a quick and easy way to do this. And then we have an immunity animation, which will toggle the body's visibility on and off. The reason I am toggling the visibility rather than adjusting the alpha of the modulus is because I'm using a cutout animation. Otherwise, you could see where the sprites overlap if I were to adjust the alpha. Legends tell of a way to use viewports to get around this, but this elusive trick continues to evade me. If you have any information on how to do this, then please let me know in the comments. Since the immunity duration can be varied based on the character that is implementing it, we can't set a static duration for the animation. So instead, we have to play the pulsing once and then set the animation to loop. Back inside of our script, I have cached the effects animation inside of a variable. And in our damaged method, we're going to tell it to play the damaged animation, which will cause our character to flash red. We then want the immunity animation to play afterwards, so we'll cue it. Since our immunity animation loops, it will continue playing indefinitely. We only want it to play for as long as we're immune, so we'll connect the immunity timer's timeout signal to our script, which we'll use to play the rest animation. This is fine and dandy, but you need to tell the player how much health they have, and maybe even how much health an enemy has. In the next tutorial, we'll learn how to implement health bars for the player and the enemy. If you want to improve the impact of your damage, then watch this video on ScreenShake, and if you're new, then join the sub club to get notified for future videos.